Hey, what's up, everybody? Phil here to play some more Enter the Gungeon because, you know, this game is just too damn awesome and has pretty much held my life hostage for any number of hours. I can't even think anymore. I can't even make proper words anymore. All I can think of is Enter the Gungeon. What you might have noticed is off-screen, off-recording, I may have gone through the secret room and defeated this son of a bitch and avenged Sir Manuel, I believe is his name. But yeah, that's about it. That's about all he did. So when beating that particular secret boss, you unlock three items, actually. It's pretty awesome. Or maybe it was four. I don't know. Either way, go through the tutorial section, look for the blatantly obvious secret room, and that will activate a quest for you to go avenge Sir Manuel. And then, you know, after that, you just go through. It's not the easiest, I'll say that much. Not the easiest. Because, Locker, I want to say his name is pretty difficult. Not the worst, not the hardest. But definitely not the easiest. I believe he shows up on the third level? It might be random. But if I remember correctly, he showed up on the third level for me in my playthrough. So keep that in mind, of course. I'm feeling a little bit more confident, even though I took some stupid damage there. A little bit more confident in my dungeon gameplay. Got some very much needed help. I've also found out that there's a lot of corrections I need to make in some of the statements I've made about... Ooh, I've never seen this before. Heart of Ice, that's cool. What are you? Tell me your secrets. Fires projectiles all and taking damage. Nice. Okay, cool. That is pretty handy. It's not, oh, it's also a heart, too. That's really fucking good, actually. That is a mark of a potentially good start to a run. If it's already given me some life and a nice little passive effect. Yeah, I'd say that's pretty fucking cool. Alright, I approve. Anyway, the master rounds, you actually only, you get them when you, be the boss in one, without taking damage. Not necessarily the level like I had originally assumed. Which, I mean, is a fair assumption, that you would have to perfect the whole level to get the master round. But, in retrospect, that's hard as fucking balls. When trying it, I could not do it. I had abandoned so many runs because I took one hit of damage, which admittedly is really stupid considering I could have gotten Hermogeny points, Hermogeny tokens, either way. So it was a dumb decision on my part, but I was kind of obsessed with trying to get those master rounds and see if I could figure them out, and I still can't seem to figure out how the shortcut guy works, and that is something I need to do my research on. So I'm breaking my rules here on the whole not do research thing. You got to. So I've come up with quite a bit more information on this game. I'm still working out the finite details of how exactly you find secret rooms. I mean, obviously you use blanks to open them, but I'm not sure if there's any like subtle clues. I mean, I can't seem to crack that. I'm working on it. I am data information is coming out every day about this game, so I am got my nose turned to the wind on that one. That's a saying. Is that a saying? We're gonna say it's a saying. Tables. Get close on that achievement. I wonder if I'm gonna get an item for doing that. That was an aggressive table flip. But realistically, there is no non-aggressive table flip, but table flip is a rather aggressive gesture. Can't really think of a time when a table flip is not construed as an aggressive gesture. Unless it's, I don't know, in the form of a comedic joke, maybe? Damn, that's a good idea. It almost makes you want to take damage. I feel like that might save my ass. Stop taking so much fucking dumb damage. That's gonna potentially cause some problems for me later on. Oh my god, quick out of screen. That is the one problem with playing in Windowed mode. That's the problem. Windowed mode, not the best idea. But, kind of got to in this particular setup, since I don't have a second mother. That's something I need to invest in. Pronto, on the double. Oh shit. What? For some reason, the gun didn't fire. It's not fire. Yeah, it doesn't fire if you're right against it. Okay, that makes sense. Okay. I don't feel like the game is broken, at least. Let's just go and let's get a heart. It seems like a waste, but I don't wanna just fucking bite the dust for a stupid reason. This is also kind of my warm-up round for the day, so. Which I shouldn't have used a recording session game for a warm-up round. But today is apparently a day of mistakes, I guess. Oh, that's right. That's right. Should today be the day? I think today might be the day. I think if I remember correctly, this room is not what I thought it would be. But that's okay. Let's see if we can win a prize. We can't win a prize until we have 25 gun casings. Well, that's a bit of a bag of dicks, but I guess we'll just roll with it. I was certain, absolutely certain, that this was going to be the room. So what I'm talking about is when you come across the rooms, the giant rooms that have a fireplace in them, if you use a water weapon or a water barrel and slide it into the fireplace, there'll be a switch that you go and hit, and that will then activate a hidden door, and then that will take you to a secret level. And I just found this out last night, and I am eager to discover it. Let's hopefully get a master round out of this. So I think for this we're just gonna use the pistol. Or just kill his lackey. It's fine too. Hit. Hopefully that is the case. Point. I just felt like it. Okay. Things are looking okay. Alright. Looking good so far. Stop! Well, there it goes. There's the master round. Fuck me! That's annoying. Although, on a positive, this ice heart is a pretty fucking phenomenal item. And it seems like it can score multiple hits of damage on a boss, so that is definitely a plus. Alright. Not the worst thing. Well, not the best thing, but not the worst thing. Hey, dog, you found a heart. That's awesome. Ooh. That is an item I am always appreciative of. Is there anything else I can do here? I totally shit the bed on getting an item. But the siren is a good one. It is a good one. Alright. Oh, sweet coffee. Oh, we'll see what happens. We'll see. You know, I forgot to mention what the hunter does. But essentially all the hunter has is this crossbow and a doggy that will periodically discover items for you. That's about it. That's the hunter. Which is pretty great. The corgi can often be pretty damn handy. I'm seeing a pattern here. There we go. Well, that was one of the easier trap rooms. Fuck you, sniper. Fuck you, rubber bullet. Fuck you, other rubber bullet. Fuck all the rubber bullets. No, they're not difficult, but they're annoying. Check out the shopkeeper, see if we've got more here. Blanks. I still don't know what this item does. I've never had enough cash to do it. Knife shield might be handy. Ooh. Oh, do we have a... Wait, the hell? This is... That's weird. The mini-map is telling me that there's a muncher box here. But I don't see... Oh, there he is. Okay. Whew. I was wondering if my brain, my game had broken, or if my brain had broken, which also is an entire possibility. Oh shit! I feel like that was gonna happen no matter what I did. I really do hate those bullet-propelled bullets, which yeah, pretty much is par the course for Into the Gungeon. Stupid damage there. It's on the dummy. Table. There we go. Easy peasy. Hey, look at that. Nice. Whoa! Tricky fucking rubber bullets. You never know when they're gonna kill you. Kinda like Brandon Lee. You never know if it's a blank or if it's gonna be a real bullet. Rest in peace, Brandon Lee. You're gone too soon. Your sister's doing nothing with the legacy. Shots there. Boink, boink. Whoa, 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 whoa. Alright. Not awful. Take a lot of dumb damage this game. Dumb damage I shouldn't really be taking, but I just am. It's like I'm not awake yet, which is entirely possible. It is my day off, I did sleep in. And I am just fucking everything up! Look at that. Can you believe that? No... no sound mind person would have fucking done that. Just dumb mistakes. Oh, thank you for that. Thank you, game. And of course I don't have a key. I'm trying to remember what you actually do here. I know I had the information pulled up. Oh, that's right. There's a secret room around here that you get, I believe the item's called the Crest of something? And you have to take it to that shrine without taking damage, otherwise the crest shatters. And I believe it opens up another room. To the Bullet King, I believe? Yeah, that's correct. Okay, cool. I got it correct. I know my informations. I do research good. Always handy. Phil do research good. Phil smart now. Phil not total dum-dum. Like commonly believed. Oh, let me guess, another treasure room? Yep, at least it's not timed. Let's go ahead and open this guy up. Oh, good God, we're okay. That's the whole room, really? Is there any? There's nothing I can get rid of, and there's no fucking fuck. Let's go ahead and get a blank. It seems like a smart choice. Appears there's nothing. Oh man, two chests I can't get to. The fuck. Oh please, whatever. Oh, great. It's the Gorgon. Again. Well played, game. Well played. I see how this is gonna go, huh? Is how you gonna now you go fucking? Why go fucking like this? It's actually a good thing that I got the that extra blank, because it's gonna be handy for that particular move. From what I've noticed, it's not that bad. I haven't figured out the exact properties of that, but some of those rounds home in on you, they change trajectory a little bit. It's a strange-ass move. It seems to be the ones that glow red have the potential to change trajectory on you. Which is a big old bag of dicks. Oh, there goes my perfect. Oh, I fucked that up real hard. Oh shit! Yeah, I can get this. One more hit. Come on, baby. Yes! Fuck. Ooh. Please give me key. Ugh. Get health, and I've never seen this item before. The fight saver? Huh. Okay. Oh, there's a homogeny point. You know, you really messed up my day, you bitch. Ugh, that is. Ugh. At least we get to floor 3, right? That's a thing. That's a thing to be happy about. Oh my god. Ugh. I feel like through anger I'm getting motivated here. Oh, that's actually good. Holy shit, really? That's pretty fucking cool. It's kind of like the axe shotgun. But, you know, way cooler. The ammo's really good for it, too. Damage is pretty solid. This is just a solid fucking gun. Save this. This and the siren. Real good weapons. That's always handy. Thank you, doggy. Yeah, we just shit the bed on finding keys this run. We really needed them, but we seem to be doing okay. Oh, I hate it when they get in the carts. Get the fuck out of there! Oh shit! Got all bullet heli. At least I got that extra heart. That actually, when you really think about it, that's what saved me in the Gungeon level. Yeah, boss fight. If I didn't have that, it would have been over. This would have been a much shorter episode. Gungeon. That's what daddy needs. It's a little weird calling myself daddy. I'm not gonna do that anymore. That's weird. That's weird. I'm not gonna make it weird. Oop, oop, oop. Flip on over, flip those tables. Thank you. Oh, good. Another chest I can't fucking open because I haven't seen a key. Ever! This bastard doesn't pick anything up. Really wish his item discovery rate was a lot higher, or even just minimally higher. Like, just a couple points higher. Because it does not feel like it happens often enough. It's maybe once every other level. Shopkeep, gimme key. Oh, thank God. Whew. All right, let's go investigate here. You know, I have yet to piss off the shopkeep, and I know that's something I've been meaning to do, just to see what happens. Whoa. Ow, why? Why would I let that happen? Didn't I hit something? Oh, should have used that for the siren. Damn it. I'm making some dumb choices here. Get to that chest, so that's a good thing. Little bomber, I'll take it. I'll feed it to the gun muncher just to see what happens. It's still a good game. Oh my God, can I just hit one? Just one? Well, I completely went absent-minded there. I don't know what happened. Oh, it's this room. So there's a trick to this room, obviously. And it requires that some of these carts will just straight up take you over to the other side. It's It's not as difficult as it seems. It's just it's obviously very cryptic. I managed to bypass it by having the grappling hook, which is a strong item to have in some cases, particularly for that room. So if you do come across the grappling hook, I recommend keeping it, because it can definitely help you pretty much bypass half of the gungeon. It's interesting, it kind of acts as almost like a secondary dodge roll. You're obviously still vulnerable to hits, but it does zip you all over the level. And I don't know what its range is, but it feels like it might be infinite. Just until it hits something. So it is pretty handy to have in your arsenal. So I'd recommend. Did you find something, boy? Did you find something? What'd you find? Let's see. No? Well, then why are you barking? Oh, because it's a fucking mimic. God damn it!
Oh no! Oh.
Okay, well, we learned something. The doggy actually serves a secondary purpose. He sniffs out mimics, which is actually. That pretty much makes the hunter probably the best choice. Because mimics can fuck your day so hard when you're low level. Or low life. Oh my god. Well, that was Enter the Gungeon, guys. I hope you enjoyed. Take it easy. Leave a like if you liked what you saw. And we'll see you again soon. Goodbye!